Vargas with FightHype.com. J.R. and Sebia. Josue, what's going on, man?
I'm doing great, man. Just ready for Saturday night. Come witness some greatness, for sure.
What's it, first of all, what's the love from the Bronx going to be like out there? How many people you got coming out?
Oh, man, I have a lot of supporters that bought tickets online from me, from Instagram, and my neighborhood, and I have people flying in from Virginia, ladies, guys, and it's going to be a show, man, and I'm definitely going to try to steal the show that night. That's the plan right there.
That's what's up, man. Listen, so, you know, I know you were over with TMT at one point, maybe with a gym, and it's not to, like, disparage any other gym or say anything bad, but it feels like this is the right fit for you. Like,
of
it
course.
Feels like this is where you're supposed to be, top rank, Puerto Rican, New York. Do you feel the same way? Like, maybe...
Of course, I fit in top rank. This is where I belong, and this is where I always wanted it to be, but when I was 17, TMT reached out to me, and we had to talk some business, and eventually I ended up being with them, but now that I'm not with them, I'm more than excited because I'm staying active the way I should be with top rank. And that's, I'm a fighter, man. I love to fight, and that's what I'm here for, and I just want to stay more busy and keep fighting and keep climbing to the top for the world title.
What did it feel like when you heard the news that you'd be fighting for a title? I mean, it's not a full title, but you're fighting
regional
for a
title. Yeah.
Right, correct. How did that feel?
It means a lot to me. It's a dream come true, just getting my first title as a professional boxer.
Right.
It's just a little warm-up for getting to getting the world title. And I'm just a step closer to reaching that goal.
And what's it feel? I mean, who do you think, aside from yourself out of Puerto Rico, it seems like there's been like a little bit of a lull. You know, we're used to having that mega Puerto Rican superstar. You got yourself now, you got Berlanga. Who do you think, aside from yourself, is the next guy to take the mantle for Puerto Rico?
Yeah, I believe they don't have one right now in Puerto Rico.
I think it's a toss-up. I think we got a lot of prospects.
Yeah,
right now.
There's a lot of prospects coming in. You have Josue Vargas, you have Josue Vargas, myself, you have Edgar Berlanga, you have John Bosa. You have all these guys that is young. We're in our 20, only 21, 22 years old, and we're coming up, man. Right. And we're gonna get there. We're gonna get to the top. And one of us is gonna be one of the greatest for representing Puerto Rico.
The new guy.
The new face. Yeah.
Correct.
And that's what I want to be. I want to be the new face of Puerto Rico, and just having Madison Square Garden sold out.
All right, well, seeing how we got Tank coming up against Gamboa, I'm sure you've spent some time with Tank. Maybe you've gotten in the ring with
of
Tank
course,
before.
Yeah.
Who do you see winning that fight? How were some of those sessions between you and Tank back in the day?
I mean, that's how I got in the team, TMT, by right. sparring Tank Davis. When TMT reached out to me and I went to Vegas, he was only signed with Tom Ring with TMT for 3 months. So Mayweather told me, yo, I have one of the best guys that I have right now, Tank Davis. Suit up and get ready to get it on. I left it great with him. That's how I ended up signing with TMT. But to your question.
One second, though. I don't want to forget this question. Is that how Floyd does it? Is that like the audition? Like, yo, this is my guy.
Yeah, you gotta fight. You gotta spar, and he gotta see what you got with his toughest guy. So his toughest guy was Tank Davis that day.
Right.
In his team, and everybody that he put in there with Tank Davis knocked him out, dropped him. You can see it on YouTube. But if you see me and Tank Davis, he couldn't do that to me. It was great work. I'm not gonna say I went in there and beat him up. I'm not gonna say he went in there and beat me up, because it was not like that. It was great work. We sparred about 8 rounds, and it was like 5-minute rounds. So just, and I was only 17 years old. He's 20 years old. He was 20 years old at that. And I was still an amateur. He was 13-0, 12 knockouts. So Mayweather saw a lot of talent in me, and that's how I ended up with TMT, like I said before.
And how do you see that fight playing out between him and Gamboa?
It's not gonna go 12 rounds. Tank Davis gonna knock him out in the later round. I say about fifth or sixth round. But Gamboa is gonna give him a tough fight in the beginning rounds.
Right.
In the beginning of the rounds, you know, because Gamboa is not no slouch. When he fought Crawford, it was a great fight. Just Crawford was too big for him. He caught him, and it was done for Gamboa.
Yo, where do we follow you? What do you want to see your fans?
You can follow me, of course, at Real Josue Vargas on Instagram. Stay tuned. Just witness greatness on Saturday night, December 14th. If you can't make it to Madison Square Garden, make sure you tune in on ESPN Plus.
You got any tickets
and
left?
And then you. Of course not, nah.
no tickets left.
It's sold out, man.
All right, man. Hey, thanks a lot, bro.
Thanks, man. Thank you.
Nice meeting you.